This is vital. Migraines, fatigue. If you are feeling tired, all of this is through the visual system. Many people are experiencing severe vision problems because they're not getting enough sunlight during the day. They have sleep problems because they're not viewing sunlight early in the day. And they're getting a lot of artificial light stimulation of the eye in the middle of the night. I'm not telling people to get away from their phone and their computers. I spend a lot of time staring at a page, drawing, writing, texting, etc., just like you do. But we're really talking about some very simple protocols that aren't just designed to improve your sleep, but are really designed to de-stressing your system. And all of these are essentially zero cost. Put simply, when you get tired, your eyelids close. And when you're alert, your eyelids are open. That is because you have neurons in your brain that, depending on your level of alertness, will make it easy or hard to keep your eyes open. Now, that's a complete duh, except that we don't often think about the relationship between alertness and where we are looking and our eyelids. Now, I learned this from a colleague of mine in psychiatry. What happens when we get tired? Our eyelids close and our chin moves down. We tend to nod out this way. If you have ever been in a classroom and the lecture is kind of drawing on or it's the afternoon, what you'll notice is that a number of students, their heads are kind of, their eyelids are closing and their chin is dropping, and then you'll see a bunch of heads bouncing back up, right? I was definitely one of those people in class. If it was post-lunch in the afternoon, it's warm, the hum of the air conditioner or whatever it is, and I'm just out, okay? When we're wide awake, the opposite happens. Our eyelids are open all the way and our chin happens to be up. And no, this is not me telling you to have good posture. However, what I learned from my colleague at Stanford is that these circuits actually act in loops. When we look up, maybe it's because these melanopsin cells are in the bottom of our retina. They are. And maybe it's because they're there in order to view sunlight, which is overhead, which it is. But that system of alertness is linked to the position of our eyes. So when we look up and our eyelids are up, it actually has a purpose. It actually creates a wakefulness signal for the brain. And so while this might seem like the silliest and simple tool that I might ever describe on this podcast, if you are feeling tired, it actually can be beneficial to the wakefulness systems of the brain, including the locus coeruleus and these areas that release norepinephrine, to actually look up, to actually look up toward the ceiling. You don't want your chin all the way back, but to look up and to raise your eyes toward the ceiling and to look up and try and hold that for 10 to 15 seconds. So this isn't looking up and closing your eyes like on a nice sunny day. That's relaxing. This is looking up and actually looking up at the ceiling. It actually triggers some of the areas of the brain that are involved in wakefulness. So if you're somebody who's falling asleep at your work, this can be very beneficial. Likewise, many people are looking at their phone all day and their chin is down, and then they're sitting at a computer that's positioned below them and they're having trouble staying awake or focusing. Positioning your computer screen up at eye level, or sometimes having it actually above eye level, can actually create wakefulness and alertness for the work that you're going to do. This is simply because of this connection between the brainstem circuits and the other neural circuits that control wakefulness and eyelids opening and looking up. Okay, so it's remarkably simple, almost laughably simple, but it's grounded in some of the most hardwired, meaning present from birth, aspects of our neural circuitry. And norepinephrine released from locus coeruleus isn't just a mouthful. It's a really interesting and powerful mechanism for how the rest of the brain wakes up. Locus coeruleus hoses the rest of your brain with norepinephrine in order to wake up those circuits for work and attention. And so eyes up is actually a route into increased alertness. Eyes down is a route into sleepiness, into reduced alertness. And I have only one friend that texts up here, like on the street, holds his phone up here. It looks ridiculous. And yet, you know, if we were trying to create more sense of alertness, if that's your goal, positioning computer screens up high, chin up, looking up if you need to kind of create an alertness signal, not always being chin down and texting or working into typewriters or reading below us, is actually going to send a recurring wakefulness signal. When things are up, we tend to be alert. When everything's focused down, including our eyes, it tends to have a more suppressive or sedative type signaling to the deeper centers of the brain.